This video is brought to you by Brilliant. I believe I finally nailed the ultimate iPhone home screen. It's a one-page ergonomic, dynamic, and time-saving setup. You can use it as a backbone and apply the organization principles, folders, stacks, and overall blueprint for your layout. I use two apps that determine the overall aesthetics, one called Widgy and another called Clear Spaces. Still, you don't necessarily need to use any of them. So, an overview. I have only one homepage. I have the app drawer on the right, and on the left I have the side widget page. On the homepage, for reachability and one-handed purposes, all apps stay towards the bottom of the screen. At the same time, all widgets take the real estate above. A full-width widget stack stays on top, while two square ones keep the apps towards the bottom of the homepage. Almost all widgets on my device are stacks, and I'll talk more about them in a second. You'll notice that I'm using a lot of blank widgets on top of the more functional ones, and for a reason. First of all, when I finish work, I'd like to avoid the urge to think about tasks. Therefore, I don't want to see them, so I just hide them. Second, with blank widgets, I get to save time if I want to hide sensitive information. Should I pass my phone to someone, or simply shoot the device for social media? For example, below the blank widget on the side screen, I have a photo widget that reminds me of the incredible family moments. For privacy's sake, however, I keep it disguised. Note that I'm not using the smart rotate of widgets nor the suggested options, although some might find it helpful. The other thing to note is that I'm keeping my interface always in dark mode. The dark mode is excellent for OLED displays, and widgets and apps look more consistent when not auto-switching between light and dark mode. Plus, it is easy on the eyes at night, and it also saves an itty-bitty battery. The sidebar page is divided into few informational sections. I keep the stats about me and my devices in the top left. I have my Apple Watch rings widget, which is visible most of the time, and below it I have my device's battery widget. Now, I don't want to always look at my batteries, but it's a swipe away when I do. Below that section I have my email widget, which helps me glance at my inbox. I use Hey as an email solution, but that could be any other email client. I wanted to discover new apps, so I placed an App Store widget beside my email in the hopes of finding something worthwhile. I'm still looking for a decent, simple kill time game, so if you have any good recommendation, please let me know in the comments below. And by the way, if you end up enjoying this video, subscribe, because why not? Finishing the side page, I have the default weather full width widget, and below it I have the Apple TV widget, which neatly ties in HBO Max as well. Basically, if I want to continue watching a movie or a TV show, I can just take it from there. Back to the homepage, I use one of my own wallpapers since I prefer to have a minimal and inspiring background, something non-default. I recently leaned towards my blurred lines pack, but you can choose any non-distracting one. I'll put a link below. So my thought process about the home screen was that I wanted to utilize only one, and any redundant apps or shortcuts had to go. I also use focus modes and some specific scenarios, which I'll show you in a second. For example, I've removed the camera app because it exists on the lock screen. I've also placed it in the control center at the bottom for easy reach. Assistive touch and double or triple tap to summon control center are things you might want to try if you haven't. Looking at the dock, all my messaging apps are inside a folder. The idea here is not so much to have an easy access to them, but rather to glance if I have any red bubbles. Now, I don't want them to take valuable space spread around the home screen, yet I don't want to miss something if I just keep them in the app drawer. So a folder in the dock is the ideal solution. Also in the dock, I keep the settings app because I use it all the time. I find it faster on many occasions than the control center. The phone app and the browser stay in the dock as well. Above the dock, I have 7 apps that I use all the time. They are work related for the most part, except for YouTube, which I use for everything else too. I've noticed that if I use another app, it is sporadic, and it doesn't justify taking space on my homepage all the time, so I prefer to summon the search for those cases. Above the app rows, I have 2 widget stacks. The left stack displays today's weather information. Now, I kept it blank before, but I think it looks more pleasant with this custom widget. This is where the app widget comes into place. If you haven't used it, it is a compelling widget creation app that you can spend days in. Suppose you don't want to learn to use it. In that case, you can choose any widget from its library of community-based creations, or even use an alternative. To make the background blend in the device, Widgy has the option to take a screenshot of my wallpaper setup and disguise my widget as if it has a transparent background. So behind that widget, I also have a quick notes page in Notion. I use it to ditch all sorts of thoughts, measurements, or ideas that come to mind. That could easily be a notes quick note or something of your choice. I use this Notion page to gather everything that matters that I can spread around the appropriate commitment apps later on. The third app in this stack is my workout notes page. It is very rudimentary, yet that's the point. I just write down the dates and the routines that I've done as far as my workouts. Plus, it's easy to see if there are too many couch days to push me even harder. The other widget area on the right is my listening section. I have the Apple Music app, Pocket Cast for podcasts, and Audible for listening to audiobooks. I can easily choose what to listen to and play right away with a simple swipe. In it, I also have a shortcut widget to trigger if I'd like to airplay whatever I'm listening to. This is the easiest way to broadcast something on the HomePods here or onto my laptop at the other office. Above the stacks, I have another full width widget stack that again uses Widgy to hold a custom weekly calendar. Since I never know which day and date it is, it helps dummies like me keep track of the space-time continuum. Under it, I hide my Things task widget. This is the quickest way to glance at what I have to focus on for the day and create new to-dos with almost no friction. Finally, in the same stack, I have my Notion recent pages. With them, I can quickly jump to a page that I've been working on recently. You might have noticed that I have a blank app space on the bottom right, and that space is usually reserved for an app that I'm currently testing or I'd like to spend time with. Also, that same space changes when I switch a focus mode. This brings me to focus modes. I have four of them. Do not disturb and sleep are nothing worth explaining. I have a kids mode that hides all my apps and displays only the kids games and educational content when needed. The rec or recording focus mode is something that I use all the time, and that is what makes up that empty app space I mentioned a moment ago. When I switch to rec, I keep the exact same layout of everything else. Still, I add a folder that holds all my video workflow apps. Example, the teleprompter app or my camera control app. Besides turning off and rejecting all notifications and calls, Rec also helps me grab whatever video app I need at the moment. Hey, future editor here. As I was working on this video, I realized that there is a faster way to toggle between focus mode off and my most used Rec one. I should have come up with this earlier because it's awesome. To save time, I created simple homepage shortcuts to trigger Rec focus mode on and off. When focus mode is off, the shortcut lives in the blank app space I mentioned earlier, and when Rec is on, I place it in my camera app folder. It's a lot faster to trigger this way, and I might even put a widget trigger for it. When in Rec mode, note that I'm also hiding all widget areas on the top to eliminate distractions. For that, I use an app called Clear Spaces. Like Widgy, which can also be used for blank spaces, by the way, Clear Spaces displays cutouts of my wallpaper as a placeholder to push my apps down. In a nutshell, creating a minimal and distraction-free interface. Swiping between the widget stacks reminds me of the Monty Hall problem. Imagine you are in a talk show and you have three doors, one of which contains a car and the other two goats. Assuming you want to win the car and you make a choice. The host, Monty Hall, opens another door with a goat behind it and asks you if you'd like to switch your pick to the remaining door. Switch or not? To find out the answer and learn to analyze problems through the framework of conditional probability, check out Brilliant's course on perplexing probability. Challenge yourself by learning how to mathematically master some of the very surprising games and experiments, including the Monty Hall game show, the boy and girl paradox, and the Tuesday paradox. Most people's intuition about the odds of winning these games are wrong, by the way. Brilliant is the best way to learn interactively and at your own pace. It replaces lecture videos with hands-on interactive problem solving. To get started for free, visit brilliant.org/thisise or click on the link in the description, and the first 200 of you will get 20% off Brilliant's annual premium subscription. If you enjoyed this video, check out my apps and software playlist where I have tips and tricks and other setup content. If you got this far, subscribe to the channel and click on the bell icon. And as always, it's been an absolute pleasure. This is E, over and out.